So the movement we looked at today is about how to use the waist movement to generate power.
因为练拳都是靠腰的带动来让手跟随的。
So boxing is about using the waist movement, using the body to generate strike on the hand.
所谓的劲都从脚底起嘛，从腰上来到手。
So the drive, starting from the feet, goes through the waist, then it delivers to the hand.
然后在练拳的过程中，我们是要，眼睛跟着手走的，远随手走的。
In practice, the eyesight should follow the hand movement.
所以。 我们今天的练拳呢，主要是来明白一些练每一个动作的一些方法要掌握的。So
the main purpose today is to understand the method with which we practice.
只有你掌握了正确的方法，你练功怎么练，它都不会走歪路。
It's only when we understand the correct method that when we train, we don't go off the course.
所以今天可以，这时候大家可以讲讲你们今天练功的感受和收获。So
Shiye invites us to speak about how we find the course today or whatever thoughts we have.
可以讲讲。
Feedback or
the
response,
sir.
Everything.
Let me show.
I like this slowly explanations. I can really.
这些细节的讲解，他能够跟上，然后他觉得很有帮助。To
learn the method is the best way.
还有没有在练功上，你们有没有一些就是更想明白的、更想了解的一些问题，或者是不知道的一些问题，可以。 问问我。
If there are any general questions regarding training, you can raise it now.
So I put that question up already in our school, but it's interesting for us, and I want to know what she says about this. That the waist movement and that powerful explosive movement, is it part of Tai Chi training in general? Is it like necessary to be aware of that explosive techniques in Tai Chi practice.
他说在练太极拳的时候，是不是也需要就是留意这种爆发性的这种发劲的方法？太极拳是不发劲的，你说？太极拳 doesn't do the explosive fajin.
You should be aware of it when you practice Tai Chi and Tai Yi.
太极是可以的，就是。 阴阳和合为太极，太极是永远是综合的、缓慢的。那么到太易就是要由快由慢的，就那个啊，它就是，那你这任何的一个动作你都可以，都可以，这个是属于是太易，这个都是可以的。这个是，这个是呢，包括这个呢，这个呢是属于是一种。 两翼拳的了，它是可以这样子的。这个，我们把任何一个动作都可以这么去练，但是呢，我们打太极拳的时候呢，它就不可以了。所以永远的是缓慢的、综合的，都挺很柔软。So
Shiye said, the concept of Tai Chi is yin and yang together. So it is the movement is always neutral, so it keeps the movement slow, no explosive movements. But Tai Yi is with the concept of Liang Yi, it separates, so it has the fast and slow different timing, and you can practice with the Fa Jing. I don't copy the movements.
So one who does practice Tai Chi should also be doing Fajin sometimes. To be aware of that separation.
Yes. Sometimes slowly, sometimes faster. Oh. Yeah?
I think his question means, if you want to improve in the internal martial arts, it is necessary to learn this Tai or Fajin
technique.
有武技，有太极，两仪三种组合的。So in
Wudang system, Tai Chi Quan has three different elements. It's in Wuji, which means stillness. It has no commitment, and there's the Tai Chi, Yin and Yang, and then
两仪。嗯，对。嗯，那个武技就是呢，我们是打坐，meditation，或者是站桩。那个太极呢，它就是呢，我们打的太极拳。 就是缓慢的，两仪就身体就是有快有慢的了，有三者要同时修炼，你才可以把这个武当的内家拳呢，打出它的风格出来。
I think this leads to another very interesting question. Does Tai Yi or Fajin technique lead to improved health?
Is there something important he said right now?
Shiye said that Wuji is similar to doing meditation and also Zhanzhuang in the stillness, and Tai Chi is like the Tai Chi Quan we do, it's slow and soft, and Liang Yi is the one that has the fast and slow and strong and weak contrast. And it's through studying all the different aspects that we can have the feature of all the Wudang studies.
Mm-hmm. Good question.
So I think it is important for health and qi cultivation, is it? The
Tai Yi.
Tai Yi.
师父问说，就是太乙的这个概念，就是对于养生，就是这样的目的是很重要的。
它的前提是首先你要有一个一定的基础。当然，两太乙这个层面呢，属于是比较高的层面了。那肯定是对养生的身体已经是很好的、很好的层面了。就身体比较强壮的层面呢，你才可以练这个拳。所以前面呢是只是它的基础。练了这个拳就是很好的。So
the question was whether the Tai Yi concept in the training helps improve someone's health, and Shiye said that it is a higher level of training that requires the practitioner to already have a foundation. So starting from the more basic training, when the body is equipped with the strength and control, then we can study the more advanced methods.
Can you help me please, because I'm my back here hurts a little bit, so what can I be not doing so well? What can I correct?
You mean correcting the movement or?
No, my posture maybe.
Okay.
My posture maybe. 当我们在不可以这么往前塌的，不可以你身体往前抠的，你要中正的呢，这地方往外，完全的。然后呢，通过腰的时候，任何动作通过腰的转动，它是可以修复的。所以练拳时候，为什么说一定要练腰？用腰来转呢？当你这个地方不是很好的时候呢，就不可以发劲。刚刚说了。 想发劲这一块层面的话呢，就是要一定身体非常好的层面，身体很好的时候呢，你就可以发劲。如果身体还不是好的时候，那我就慢点了。但是任何一个动作，我的腰，一定要腰转。所以发劲的时候呢，使劲的时候呢，它就是一种身体比较好、强壮的时候才可以练的。
So the key point is to have an upright posture, keeping the center. and the rotation movement, similar to what we practice doing Fajin, the rotation helps you correct and repair your problems. And when you have the sufficiently strong condition of your body, then you can actually do the Fajin. So this is an indication.
很多练拳的练拳之后啊，这里原来痛的都会练好。
So many people with pain at the lower back can actually recover through training in martial arts.
在我们中国叫这个地方叫他们叫腰椎盘突出。腰椎啊，就是这地方有问题，就是腰椎盘突出，就是这里边这地方哎这一节鼓出来了呢，突出来了这一个，这个呢拱出来了，它就是不能动。 他到医院看不好的，他只要练拳呢，他就练好。这个是在我们那里很多的一些就是实证啊，就是说大家来中国练拳的，这个练好了。So
it's a very common condition that if you have a displacement in your column, it's actually very difficult to correct. But there are many cases where people have improved this through training in martial arts.
No, it's just a pain now. I don't have, after doing the exercise, I don't have...
So this is from the practice? Yeah. Oh,
okay. That's why I was asking, because I think I didn't make it right. But
now I think I understood. It's now pain. Yes, it's now pain. It's not
pain. It's not pain. It's 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 pain. It's
So you, it may mean that it does not have the perfect connection.
Oh,
okay. So 通着不痛，就是说这个人身体在好的时候，他是不会痛的。开始一练就痛，说明这地方不是很好。
So maybe there's some problem that presents itself when you exercise.
Okay.
我们中国叫中医里面说是通着不痛，痛着不通。
So if it connects, it's not painful. But if it has pain, it's not connecting.
There's a principle question about the Tai He Chuan form we are learning. Sometimes you can read it's a very old form, and other people write it was developed in the 80s, last century. So what is the origin?
他查一些资料，就是说我们要学习的太和拳，有人在网上写说这是非常古老的套路。
但是他也有看到有人写，这可能是80年代的时候编的套路，但他不知道哪一个是对的。太和拳呢是根据后来根据我们刚才叫太和山，根据这个名字呢来取的。说太和为什么叫太和？我刚才呢是希望天下大同，天下和谐和平，永远都是和睦的，就是和平的，就是这么个意思。说太和拳呢也是在。 近些年呢，是创编出来的道拳法，是一个老道长创编的。
是比较新的。时间不是很久，对。It's actually not too long. So, the name follows 太和山, which is the previous name of Wudang Shan.
对，名字是很老的。The
name is really old. It's before Wudang Shan. And 太和 it means, the wish for harmony over the world.
名字很老，对，这个拳呢，它里面呢，动作呢其实很简单，不复杂，但是呢，它的腰里面就比较高，就是要求比较高，也就是说对内家拳的了解，你要有这个基础的话，你这个拳就打得很好看。如果说你这个武术的基础不是很好呢，这个拳你就练得不好看。So
the form has relatively simple movements. But has high demand on understanding of internal power. So if you have understanding in internal martial arts, you will be able to make the form well.
等我把这套拳给你们教完了之后，我从头练一遍，让你们看一下，你就知道这个拳它的一种刚柔并进、快慢相间，对这种阴阳各见所长的这种表现。
So when we finish learning the sequence of the form, Shiye will do a complete demonstration. There we can see how the form has combined contrasting movements with different speed and power usage.
If I understand good, Tai Chi Chuan is a part of the Liang Yi system, not the Tai Chi. Is that correct?
It belongs to the Liang Yi system.
Mm-hmm. And what is the connection, for example, with the Wuxing Chuan? For example, first the Tai Chi Chuan, then the first level the Wuxing Chuan. What is the connection between the Liang Yi forms?
You mean the order of learning these things, or 他是说,
五星,
Tai Chi Wuxing Chuan 跟这些,
都是属于两一拳的。
那他学习有没有就是顺序?
如果按顺序的话呢, 肯定是先学太和拳, 然后再学两一拳, 学那个五星拳。
It should be starting with 太和拳, then 五行拳.
因为太和拳比较简单些, 五行拳呢比较难一点。
It's much easier.
五行拳 is more difficult.
所以把这个打好了, 这个前面打好了, 你再上这里来, 它就 easy. 如果没有这个, 直接上这里来, difficult.
So starting from 太和拳, then learning 五行拳 is easier. But without the basics, you have to jump up there, it's harder.
So I have a question which has to do with what you did today. And in the forms, I got a bit confused about what's happening with yin and yang, because it happened so fast. Our Shifu, he showed us some movements in Tai Chi, and you understand, you know, the part that is moving and the part that is quiet. Can you maybe tell us a bit more about what is happening? In the movement.
You mean in the context of recognizing yin and yang? Or
yeah, because I have a feeling all of the relaxation is kind of forced into that end point. It's like everything is to the end, no? And I'm not really sure what's happening with yin and yang in this kind of explosion. It's very different from
他说他有一点不明白在我们今天学的动作里面要怎么分辨阴跟阳，因为好像从
放松动作到最后全部都是发力的，那放松其实就是柔和的，那发力到了之后，这其实就是一种阳的表现，快的、猛的。但是呢，这个拳今天所练的呢是里边比较招数比较难的动作，我先把难的动作拿出来让你们练，会了之后我们再学其他的就比较容易了。 先练难的，这个是里面这个拳里面是比较难的，那后面前面的这些简单的呢，我们放在以后再学，知道吧？先学难的，后学容易的，这个拳呢就练得很好。So
the relaxing parts are actually the more recessive and soft movements, and when the power is coming out, it's the hard.
So it's very short.
Yeah.
And
and the two movements are the more difficult. Parts of the form. First we will practice this and then when this is done, then doing the form will be easy.
对，所以说我们先练难的，后练易的，那就难的就变成容易的。
So if we start with the difficult part, then we do the easy part. The whole thing becomes easier.
对，这样的话你这套拳就会练得很漂亮。
It will make the form beautiful.
对，如果先学简单的，你在后面的时间呢再学难的，他练习的时间太少了，所以说呢这个拳呢不容易练那么好。So
if starting from the easy part and then at the end study the harder part, then there's not enough time devoted for the practice for the more difficult components.
我们用两天的时间练这个比较难的动作。
We will spend 2 days on the more difficult parts of the form.
后面呢，我们再学简单的，然后把它一组合，一合拢，它就是一个完整的拳法了。In
the later days, we will do the sequence of the form with the easier parts. Then when put together, it will be complete.
这个是我们多年那种教学的经验。So
this is from the educational experience that this works.
对，先难后易。
Difficult than easy.
Yeah, often is easy.
then it's easy.
This is 天下难事必定于易.
So the difficult things, we start with the easy part.
对，我们把它拆出来就是一种简单的教学方法了.
The easier method for teaching.
Okay.
One short question. Very short. Can you connect Fajin with the spinal movement?
他是问说这个发青的动作是不是有连接到那个脊椎？对，腰啊，所以说所有的动作都是腰，不是说要叫你们转腰吗？
Mm-hmm.
对，it connects, turning the waist is connecting to the spine.
Fajin goes through. Yes. Each movement goes through because here you have the root connect with the ground and come up high, explosive. So always goes through.
你们把这个拳练好了，你们会越来越喜欢武当的功夫.
When you have learned the form well, and then you will like Wudang martial art more and more.
Yeah, of course. 对，因为你知道了练拳的一些方法了.
Because you already understand the methods.
对，方法第一.
The method is most important.
Where do is the force direction going in the sense of application? Does it go more upwards? Does it go forward or diagonal somewhere in
Are
between?
Are you asking particularly in the movements we do today, or that as example? 他是问说，他想了解在今天所练两个发劲的动作，他想知道这个应用的时候，他的力量应该往什么方向走？这里。
对啊。
就是up，对，你看，看到，对，你看，都是这里的。My
question: why not knock?
这里，对，这里，你看，对，up，对，up呢，都是up。
By doing that, you block energy here and force it in here.
Yeah. 嗯，嗯，easy.
There's a movement in the other form that uses this.
Fragen auf Deutsch, die wir übersetzen sollen für jemanden?
Hat noch wer Fragen in Deutsch? Irgendwas schwierig zu formulieren?
Did you understand your question?
No,
said it was too fast.
She said it was very interesting, and she is happy that she survived the first training.
She said it was very interesting, and she is happy that she survived the first training. She said it was very interesting,
and
she
当你练到第三天的时候，你会更爱这套太和拳了。
So the third day, Shiye expects that we will really start to like the form.
Can we also ask something about Qigong?
他们可以问气功有关的问题吗？可以啊。
By the routine Qigong, why is this position with the hand?
他说五行气功为什么要阴阳？对，这是为阴，我们叫呢，子丑寅卯辰巳午未申酉戌亥，这个是中国的一些文化了，比较复杂了。天干十二地支，这个我好像不会翻译。对，你说你告诉他，这是中国的一些传统的阴那个地支，十二地支的文化，就是这个阴阳五行的一些文化了。 所以你就知道阴阳就行了。如果说你知道了解我们中国的这些文化的话，你就会知道这代表什么意思了。所以说你就要把这个手一拿就可以了。这叫什么阴阳？阴阳和合为太极。所以说，我们的西方的这些学员呢，如果说不了解。 中国的文化的话，以只能说从形体上学得很好，学得很像，但是从内在上去了解它呢，就有点难了。
So the movement you can understand as yin yang, it together it means tai chi, but it has some context in counting system in Chinese. So it's only through understanding some of the details in the cultural context that you can really appreciate this.
Do you think, can we clarify this in a blog post or something? Because he explained a lot. Is it, I think it's a lot of information.
Was it recorded or?
Yes, it's recorded, so you can review after.
I can try.
Okay, we will try to translate directly and I will try to inform you after. Mm-hmm. Because it's a complicated context. Please explain.
所以就是说，刚才有这些解释有录下来，那师父是说。 可能我们接下来试着把这些重点整理一下，就是说，师爷你怎么回答这些问题，可能就放在我们那个学院的网站上。可以，所以说，等你想更好的了解这个内家拳，你就要了解一些中国的一些传统的文化了，你的阴阳五行学说。So to better understand the internal martial art, it is required that you dive into some of the traditional Chinese culture. And with the context, you really see the meaning, the connection.
这叫既然不动，感而遂通了，这个就有点难了。这个就是易经里面的文化了。
May I have my one question? Why is the difference between male female?
他问说是男女的手势为什么是反过来的？一，那我们叫。
左为阳嘛，右为阴，是负阴而抱阳，充气以为和，它就是阳抱阴就这样的。Yeah,
because the left hand represents yang, therefore it is different for male and female because it's yin and yang.
Because the movements are on both sides, all the movements.
Yes, but the hand posture has meaning corresponding to yin and yang, therefore corresponding to male and female. Left hand is yang.
Fu yin or bao yang.
If you think of yin and yang, then you also think that some people have stronger yang and stronger yin. Yes, maybe. And then if I do automatically use the other hand, is it then maybe my right hand? You know what I mean? Because if I rather use the yang hand automatically, is it then maybe for myself the correct hand? Or do I really, because I'm female by my biological sex, have to use my left hand, my right hand? I'm confused now.
Complicated.
还是如果是有惯用左手或惯用右手的，是代表这个人他有阴阳不平衡或者是什么样的倾向？这没有，这只是他的一个，我们讲的是。
左脑和右脑的一个开发的一个发育不同，但是阳永远是在左边，我们中国来讲，这左为大，啊，这为次，中间为君主，就是他是为，我们是左边为阳的，永远都是这样的，啊，这个跟那个说喜欢用右手喜欢用左手，那个没关系。So
being left or right-handed is more about which side of the brain you're more used to operate with. But traditionally, the left hand corresponds to the yang side and is also a higher position.
所以在我们那边很讲究，在我们中国很讲究。就比如说，两个人排在一起，我们就是左手为大，那就是说，如果说你和一个你的长辈在一起，你就应该让你的长辈在你的左边，就左边为大，我们是这样的，就左边为阳。
So the left side corresponds to the higher position. So, for example, in an occasion where you have to stay with a senior person, then it can be that you should let the senior person be on the left hand side. It applies to some occasions.
对，所以我们中国文化就左青龙，右白虎，龙比虎要厉害。那是左边为阳，左右边为阴的。
So for example, the left-hand side has the dragon, and right-hand side has the tiger. And a dragon is at a higher position than the tiger.
对，其实我们的文化就是这样子。
This is the cultural context.
I know, but like if I do, I know the dragon of course, like a woman is wrong.
Don't you?
And it's wrong.
So
I always have to do it.
I think it's also about in Qigong to bring out harmony inside. And for male, usually, yang is prominent, and for female, it's opposite. So maybe inside some disturbance if you do something. But yeah.
Yeah, but that's what I mean. So you think that I have to. Bring it in harmony, or is maybe my harmony for different?
I'm wondering, you know, if it really, do you think that everybody has the reason to face a certain harmony, or if you think in the idea that we have an individual harmony?
I know what you mean,
yeah.
But the reason the
male use left hand and female use left hand first is because of yin-yang prominence.
Okay.
So for male we need this yang energy, female needs this yin energy to stay calm inside and to stay quiet.
Okay.
It's a freezing quiet, like a wu qi. Stay quiet and bring back harmony, that's why you have the hand position. Maybe sometimes you feel not comfortable or you need a practice.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah.
So you
become more quiet and breathing relaxed.
OK. Mm-hmm. 那就明天见.
We'll see you again tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
谢谢，
辛苦了。
好，谢谢。